And welcome back, everyone. Most of us go to the hospital or the doctor's office expecting to get well. But the truth is, tens of thousands of patients die every year from medical errors and healthcare-related infections. Tonight, Lori Kinney brings us part one of a two-part series on deadly medical mistakes.
Misdiagnoses, fatal infections, drug overdoses, even surgeries on the wrong organs or limbs. Back in 1999, an Institute of Medicine report called To Err Is Human highlighted the shocking problem of medical errors, blaming them for 98,000 deaths annually. That didn't include all hospital infections, which the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention says kills 99,000 a year. Janet Corrigan was one of the authors of the 1999 report. She says its mandate was clear.
That it should be a national priority to address the issue of medical errors.
The report called for reducing errors by half over 5 years. So 10 years later, where do we stand?
We don't know today if we're getting safer or not.
In fact, Dr. Carolyn Clancy's data suggest the opposite. She heads the Federal Agency for Healthcare Research and Quality, which reported in 2008 that preventable medical injuries are growing by 1% each year. But no one knows for sure, because despite the 1999 IOM report's call for mandatory national public reporting, it doesn't exist.
Somewhere between 20 and 30 states have some kind of reporting systems, and these range from mandatory, certain events must be reported, to reporting of near misses, almost mistakes.
The patchwork of reporting systems also includes data from Medicare and soon will include federally certified patient safety organizations, which collect confidential data but don't cover every state or region. So researching safety records of hospitals and providers is difficult or impossible for patients. The American Medical Association offers a blunt assessment of why public reporting failed to take hold.
Physicians and hospitals are often afraid to report errors due to litigation that's going to occur.
A Hearst newspaper's investigation pinpoints other areas in which we've fallen short in fighting medical errors in the last decade. For example, only 9% of hospitals have computerized medical records, and only 17% have computerized prescriptions. Hospitals routinely charge and get insurance payments for correcting errors, thereby making more than if there'd been no error. And a National Patient Safety Center set up per the IOM report is perennially underfunded.
I do think it is time at this 10-year anniversary to take a very close look at where we're at with safety and what steps need to be taken next.
Now, a new administration has the ball in its court.
The Obama administration says patient safety will be an important component of health care reform, and it might not be a moment too soon. Some authors of the original IOM report say more people are dying now than when the report was written. At the White House, Lori Kinney, 4029 News.